Sunday morning. Morning and running. We're planning to go for a walk, guys. But still, my husband feels sleepy.
Okay. She's too much of a morning person. He's up early, I just don't want to get up, let alone get up.
It's time check. It's 6 o'clock, past 6 o'clock na. We're supposed to go for walk by early. Early 6 o'clock. But it's already past 6 o'clock, guys. Okay, guys. Update you later.
Message me.
Hi, guys. We're ready to go. Aray. What about Mike? What about Mike?
Mike's brother passed away.
Who's that?
Mike's sister.
Hon. Honey. Just the first.
Paranoid.
Wow.
Just been blocked. Your brother's in there.
Yeah, that's fine. It's okay. Just put a space for Joker. It's a holiday Sunday today, guys. It's Sunday. So it's a market day as well. Sorry. What time is it now? So it's around what time now? We're too late already, huh?
Yeah, you're slow.
You are slow.
6:30.
Oh, it's already 6:30. It's late, yes. Now. But still, the sun is energy still. Forgot the market after we walk. We got a vegetable market. We're buying onion, garlic, cauliflower, cabbage, and other stuff. We're supposed to go out 5 o'clock. 5:30.
Yeah,
but it's fine.
When I used to work, I used to get up at 5:38. Hey, I don't know why that I'm retired. I don't want to get up. It's like, I don't have to. You'll notice everything in the U.S. is fast-paced. We keep going, working. But here, everything's laid back, so you just don't really... You just like, it's like what they say, Filipino time. Whenever. You know?
That's how here in the front.
Morning here.
We have, I call it Karinderia everywhere. Everywhere there's a Karinderia. Everywhere here there's a we call it Karinderia. Because Filipino loves to eat. Filipino, aside from Filipinos, loves rice, it also loves to eat.
I don't know how they stay so skinny. I eat all the food.
Rice is life. They're saying rice is life. Growing. For a Filipino, rice is life. I haven't seen you. We also a Chapel of Mormons there. That's the Chapel of Mormons.
Yeah, it's not all Catholics here. So we got the Mormon Church, you got the Jehovah Witnesses, you got Catholic, Roman Catholic.
Mm-hmm. And the other one, the Iglesia ni Cristo. They call it in an abbreviation or shortcut, IMC. That's the surroundings. It looks it's gonna be hot again tonight today.
Reminds me when we used to go to Virginia, I used to sit there and point at all the churches. There would be like 24 churches. It's all the same here.
Yeah, I remember that one. I remember that one. Yeah. When Art go to work, driving all the way to the highway, or how do you call that place?
That was on our main road.
Yeah.
Main road.
Yeah, actually. He drove to the main road, and he showed me a lot of Catholic church. It's a Sunday. The market will gonna be busy today. It's a market day. It's a market day. Oh, there's a Mormon there, a foreigner.
It's about right. 6:30. I can look up.
It's already hot, honey.
It's not hot. It's that sun. It's hot.
It feels. So it's hot for me.
Chin on my glasses, I can't even look up. It's such a bright.
The sun feels hot for me.
Right.
Oh my god, it's a big dog. Oh no. Hmm. We just walk over here. You walk over here, hon. You just unchained.
It has been lately. Usually it's, we get some pretty good waves out here. Was it 7.5 or whatever it was?
Yeah.
They were having warnings here because they thought they would have an after effect from it. A tsunami. They were predicting maybe 6-8 foot waves, but the water stayed calm the whole time, but
yeah,
they closed the schools and everything down.
And thanks God.
Preparing for it.
So really thanks God.
Yeah.
Praise God for that.
You would thought to, you know, I've lived through a lot of stuff. I'm not ready for that one. I think the worst one I've had was a tornado. Lived in Florida. Over 20 years. It's a hurricane state. Had a lot of tropical storms. I don't remember any hurricanes. Moved to Virginia, the first thing I hit was a hurricane.
Mm.
And a typhoon, and then we had the tornado there. And here I've been with a few earthquakes. Mm. It was a typhoon. Had a couple typhoons.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Which are typhoons are similar to hurricanes in the U.S.
Ondoy. Yeah, that's the Tamigin Island, honey.
Yeah, I see it.
Yeah.
A lot of times we can't see that island. It's still kind of hard, but you can see the outline of it.
The waters looks, what the color is that? It's an aqua green?
Yeah, it's aqua.
Turquoise?
Turquoise
like that?
Turquoise color.
It's a turquoise
water.
Color of the water.
Yeah.
Some people are camp here, came here for their exercise also. We are really happy and enjoying walking at the boulevard every morning. Not even morning, we do also afternoon, right hon? Right hon?
Yeah.
We also do afternoon. If we can, we come back by afternoon, so.
About 6, same time.
Yeah. And then sometimes there's a.
This one, sunset's coming down.
And there's a times also that we just bring our food here for dinner. It's nice.
Make a picnic out.
Good morning.
Good morning, po. Oh, there is a fishing boat over there. The tents are still on stand.
Yeah.
They're still standing, guys. After the holiday.
Get a couple good storms coming here.
No.
Top of Easter. You just don't stay in front of them. They can build them just to get the shade. And sit down.
Wait, now my husband noticed about this one, guys. About this.
They get innovative.
And he asked me, what is that for? Is that for basketball? Yeah. Oh, take a look, guys. See how improvised the people are making.
They're well at improvising stuff, yeah. To play.
Yeah, we kids are love to play basketball.
For sure. Well, that's a pretty tall boy. Not all Filipinos are sure.
They improvise it. How they gonna make a ring, basketball ring, guys. So they use that one, a bucket.
And then the other
they make a hole at the bucket.
You'll see the kids out in the street on holidays or weekends putting their slippers. What do you call that game where they're throwing their slippers?
Yeah. I don't know what,
how do you,
yeah, I know that one. Yeah. Stop again over there. stop first here. Careful, honey. Our break again, guys. Just to drink tea, apple cider tea.
Yeah, it's supposed to help with my cholesterol, but I don't know. Stop feeding me so much food. Loves to cook.
You did fasting yesterday?
I tried to fast yesterday.
You did fasting yesterday, but it didn't help.
Man. It's like, you know, I've always ate breakfast in the morning, so I thought, like, okay, I'll do a fast till lunchtime. Man, my stomach was going berserk, and I felt tired. I'm like, I gotta have breakfast to give me a kick in the morning and get me going, but I don't know how many people do fasting where they go, you know, from 6 o'clock at night till...
That's
6 o'clock. Oh, it's 6 p.m. Yeah, they started, it says 6 p.m. till, I was longer than that, but...
Yeah, if medical concern for laboratories,
yeah.
10 p.m. late evening, 10 to...
The one I read was 6, or 6 you to... You're trying to do a 12 to 14, 16 hour fasting. Tell that to my body when it's hungry. That is craving sugar. I don't know what it's doing, but... doing something. I always had to have breakfast when I worked. I gotta have first thing, get up, eat something. Get me a morning pickup, but I figured now that I'm older, not working, I haven't worked since I'm 60. So your body slows down. I can't eat like I used to. I mean, I still eat pretty good, but I can't sit there and eat a full big steak anymore like I used to. I miss steaks. It's hard to find steaks here. So you keep looking. We had that steak in...
Where?
Pampanga.
Pampanga?
Up in Suga. What was that?
You mentioned it before.
Yeah.
Prime steak.
Yeah,
it's not a prime steak.
Yeah, prime steak.
I don't know. I can't remember the restaurant.
But it's like American style restaurant.
Yeah.
They have, you know, some. It's we have an Olive Garden, but there's only one or two in the whole all the Philippines. There's no Red Lobster. There's a few Texas roadhouses, right?
Mm.
Yeah, they got a few Texas roadhouses, but where we're at, you're not gonna find that. I don't even think we had that in Manila when we stayed in Manila, Texas Roadhouse. Unless they got one now.
That's the restaurant in US?
Texas Roadhouse. Look at this ocean. Beautiful this morning. Can you hear the waves coming in? When we stayed at the family house, we could hear that in the morning. We're down farther. We're the same distance when it comes to houses to the beach, but we have more houses behind us. Front of us, to the beach. So, family house, you got the family house, then you got her cousins, and then it's all the way to the beach. There's only maybe one other house to get to the beach.
It's only trees. are blocking
trees,
with that house.
Here we got the church and all this other stuff blocking us, so we don't hear the waves as much. You could hear it at the other house. But right now they're not.
And we're ready to go. Continue our walking. Good?
I'm good, baby doll.
Okay.
Come on, shorty. Let's go.
What's your step? Okay. Still have walk from here up to there. Continue walking again. That's the fishing boat here, guys. Not really a fancy boat. We came back here, guys, at the tent because he forgot his phone. Oh my god, I ran all the way from there going back in here because I really wanted to get back his phone. My gosh, I'm the one scared because, yeah,
I told
right here because possible
it.
Here.
I got tracking.
If you have, if you leave something really important stuff, if somebody will pick that one, I'm pretty sure you will not gonna get back to you. Oh my god, honey.
She was running, girl. She was running.
Because he always...
That girl's running. I couldn't run.
He always for. I just go mostly. He forgot everything.
I'll be 65 next month. I ain't running for nobody.
Oh my god.
My knees ain't handling that.
When I asked him, are you sure you brought your...
Yeah, because I've never...
You brought with you your... Phone. You bring with you your phone. You're really sure? Because I'm ready to go. I'm ready to run. I just give the phone and this one. I give it to him. And then I run. Oh my god! I almost collapsed.
Well, how old are you? 46?
You should be able to. It's lucky we found it. Where's your phone?
Right there in my pocket.
It's lucky we found it there.
Now you know the age gap. We're 18 years?
She's
46
years.
And I'm 64 right now.
Oh my gosh, honey. I'm the one who's scared.
But I was the one watching your little cute.
Your...
I got to watch your little cute butt wiggle wiggle when you're running.
Yeah, I'm the one who's scared, guys, of losing his phone because his phone is everything is in there.
Yeah.
Access on his everything.
Yeah.
So if he lost that one, no. It's hard for him to get another phone again.
She gets paranoid quickly.
If he lost that one, I give back that old phone. But it's not really like that, but because his phone is more upgraded than mine, so I'm afraid to lose that.
Are you calm down? Breathe the ocean air.
Okay, guys. We're going back now. And then we finish walking na. That one is already finished because I almost run for meters, 150 meters. 150 or 200 meters, guys. So that's enough for now. We will go to the vegetable market. Then that's it, and we're having a breakfast later. Okay, guys. That's for now. Please like and subscribe, guys. If you haven't yet, please like and subscribe. That's for now. Honey, say
hi. Yes, bye, let bye. Us help us grow our channel, please. Thank you.
Okay, okay, guys. See you on the next one. Bye. Hi, guys. We finished on our market day. That's my husband holding the some stuff. Holding a lot of stuff over here, guys.
I don't know how much we spent. A lot of vegetables.
It's heavy, guys.
She won't give it to me. Did we did we spend 500 pesos?
No more than.
No more than. So all of that and meat,
including the meat.
And this meat. And this too. Five. So $10 for everything we got here. Vegetables and meat.
Maybe we spend 700.
Maybe 700. Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe. So about $12. $12 to $14, somewhere around there.
We have already. Okay.
Get okras, bananas, tomatoes,
cauliflower,
mangoes, green mangoes. You getting yellow mangoes?
No, the corn.
Yeah, corn on the cob. Cabbage. Tomatoes. So, and what did you get for pork or beef?
Pork.
She got pork?
Yeah. Fresh pork.
Fresh pork here.
Huh?
So.
I'm gonna cook and go.
What are you gonna cook, sweetheart?
Milaga.
Oh, my favorite. One of my favorites, Milaga. There you go.
Hey, guys. So, pork. Yeah. Ang pinamili in the market, and I found that the corn, it's a native corn, so that must be good. Okay, guys, and I'm going to cook the nilaga. Okay, and I got also a taro over here, and that onion, taro. I'm gonna put in nilaga like this. I'm gonna put that one in nilaga and cabbage. Put some banana also. Okay, guys. I'm gonna cook for our breakfast now. I'm gonna make breakfast. Okay. I'm cooking fried rice, guys. This is my breakfast. And that one. It's a vegetable. I make my husband already his breakfast. Egg and apple. Let's eat, guys. This is my breakfast, fresh vegetables, and that's my husband already ready.
Yeah,
breakfast,
eggs and apples. What you got here? You got Fish.
Yeah, vegetable.
And vegetables. You wonder why
mixed
Asians,
vegetables.
You wonder why Asians live longer.
With rice. Fried rice. As I have told you, fried rice or rice is life.
What is a half crate of eggs? 15? You don't do it by the dozen. You do it by like half. What's that? 15 eggs?
Half of tray.
How much?
Yeah, 15.
Yeah, 15. So a tray is 30 eggs, and we get a half a tray for 190 or 180.
100 something.
Yeah. So that's.
Fine by you guys.
And I think the U.S. now. Eggs are like $3 for a dozen for 12.
It's a fresh vegetable, guys. Sarap ng bulo talaga, guys. Vegetable. Fresh vegetable.
What do you want? Uno?